Hello and welcome guys to a new video of EduCeption where we will begin with section formula. In this video, we will recap with distance formula, we'll tell you about section formula, we'll tell you about midpoint formula, and we will also tell you about centroid of a triangle. We will also solve a few basic sums based on these particular topics. If you like our video, do hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to our channel EduCeption and share this video with all your friends. Without further ado, let's dig in. First, let's recap with distance formula. Now, if two points are given in a Cartesian system, A with the coordinates x1, y1 and B with the coordinates x2, y2. How do we calculate the distance between these two points? That is what the ability of the distance formula is, to calculate the distance between two points in the Cartesian system. What is that? AB is equal to the square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole squared. Okay, it is pretty easy. You just put the values and you will get the distance. Okay, now we'll move on to section formula. What is section formula? If I join these points AB by a straight line, okay, and I take any particular point R in between the two points with the coordinates xy. This particular point divides the line segment in a particular ratio. Let the ratio be m is to n. Now, sectional formula gives us the ability to find the coordinate of this particular point R which divides the line segment in a given ratio. What is that formula? It's very simple. It is x equal to mx2 m into x2 plus nx1 n into x1 divided by m plus n. Similar thing with the y coordinate, y is equal to my2 m into y2 plus ny1 n into y1 divided by m plus n. So this is the sectional formula, and this gives us the ability to find the coordinate of a point that divides a given line segment in a given ratio. Okay, you have to learn this particular formula by heart because it is very important. Now, there is also an easy way to remember this formula. What is that? For example, take this ratio m. Now, m is multiplied by the coordinates that are opposite to it, mx2 and my2, and this particular ratio n, it is divided by the coordinates that are opposite to it, nx1 and ny1, x1 y1, and in the denominator it's always the sum of the two ratios, m plus n and m plus n. Okay, so this is the easy way to remember sectional formula. Now we move on to the next thing, which is midpoint formula. Midpoint formula. What is midpoint formula? Let me take two points A and B. I'll join both the points. Let the coordinates of A be x1, y1 and the coordinates of B be x2, y2. Now I take a particular point R which is in between A and B. That means the length of AR is equal to the length of RB, and I take the coordinates of R as X and Y. That means the R is dividing this line segment in the ratio 1:1, because length of AR is equal to the length of RB, R is in the midpoint. Now midpoint formula gives us the coordinates of R. Now how to do this? We can simply use the sectional formula and get a very beautiful formula out of it. How? X over here is equal to mx2 plus nx1. M over here is 1 and n over here is also 1. So 1 into x2, that's x2, plus nx1, 1 into x1, that's x1, divided by m plus n, that means 1 plus 1, which is 2. And y, my2, 1 into y2, that's y2, plus ny1, that's y1, divided by m plus n, that is 1 plus 1, which is 2. So we get this very beautiful formula, that is x is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 and y is equal to y1 plus y2 by 2. This is the midpoint formula. Okay, now we'll move on to the next thing, that is centroid of a triangle. Centroid of a triangle. Now first of all, what is centroid of a triangle? Let me draw a triangle over here. The triangle has three vertices, A, B and C. A, B and C. What is the centroid of this triangle? The intersection of all the three medians. That means this, this and this. This particular point is the intersection. This is G, the centroid. Okay. All the four are points and all four points will have coordinates. Let the coordinate of A be x1, y1. The coordinate of B be x2, y2. And coordinates of C be x3, y3. And let the coordinates of the centroid be x, y. Okay. Now, what is the centroid? G is the centroid. And we can calculate that very easily with the formula. The formula is x is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3. And y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. That means x is the sum of all the 3x coordinates divided by 3 and y is equal to the sum of all the y coordinates divided by 3. This is the centroid of a triangle. Okay, I hope you have understood all this. Now we'll move on with a few basic sums based on these topics so that you have a better understanding. Let's begin with the first sum. Number one, calculate the coordinates of the point P which divides the line segment joining A minus 3, 3 and B 2 minus 7 in the ratio 2 is to 3. Okay, so a very simple problem in which you have to just apply the formula. Let me draw the line first. A minus 3, 3 and B 2 minus 7. Okay. The point P is dividing this line segment in the ratio 2 is to 3. So P, let the coordinates of P be xy, 2 is to 3. Now what was sectional formula? It was x equal to mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n and y is equal to my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. Over here, m is equal to 2, n is equal to 3. Okay, x1, y1, x2, y2. Let's write it out. x1, y1, x2, y2. Now, let's simply put everything in the formula and we will get the answer. M is 2, x2 is 2. Plus n is 3, x1 is minus 3, okay, divided by m plus n, 2 plus 3, that's 5, and y, my2, 2 into minus 7, plus ny1, 3 into 3, divided by 5, okay. So, let's calculate it out. 2 2's are 4 minus 9 divided by 5 minus 14 plus 9 divided by 5. Okay. So we get minus 5 by 5 and minus 5 by 5. So ultimately we get the points minus 1, minus 1. Hence the coordinates of the point P are minus 1, minus 1. So this particular point divides the line segment AB in the ratio 2 is to 3. This is the most simple way to solve sectional formula sums. Okay, now we'll move on to the next sum. Moving on to the next sum, we have the midpoint of the line joining 2A4 and minus 2, 2B is 1, 2A plus 1. You have to find the values of A and B. This is a very easy question from midpoint formula. Now first let me write what was the midpoint formula. X equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 and y is equal to y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay, let me now construct the line A 2a4 and B minus 2 2b. Okay, the midpoint, let it be called P. The ratio, I mean the coordinate, is given 1 2a plus 1. Now this is x1 y1, this is x2 y2, and this is x y. We'll simply put everything in that formula and we will get the answer. Let's do that. X, that means 1 over here, is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, that means 2a minus 2 by 2. And one more for y, 2a plus 1 is equal to y1 plus y2 by 2, which is 4 plus 2b by 2. Let me solve both the equations. 2 is equal to 2a minus 2. 2a is equal to 4. Therefore, a is equal to 2. We get the value of a over here. 2a plus 1 is equal to 2b plus 2. Both the 2's get cancelled out. Then we have 2a plus 1 is equal to b plus 2. I'll put the value of a over here, which is 2. 2 2's are 4 plus 1 is equal to b plus 2. 5 minus 2 is equal to b. Therefore, b is equal to 3. Hence, we also get the value of b. A is 2 and b is 3. Now, we'll move on to another sum. Moving on to the next sum, we have find the coordinates of the centroid of the triangle whose vertices are A 03, B 1 minus 1 and C 5 1. Also find the length of the line joining A and the centroid. Okay, I've told you the formula of the centroid, which is X equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3 and Y is equal to Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 divided by 3. Okay, now let's construct the triangle. A 03, B 1 minus 1 and C 5 1. Okay, now the centroid will be over here, G. Let's calculate G. X will equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, which means 0 plus 1 plus 5 divided by 3, and y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3, that is 3 minus 1 plus 1 divided by 3. So 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 divided by 3, that's 2. 3 minus 1 plus 1, that's 3, 3 divided by 3, that's 1. So the centroid of this triangle is 2, 1. Now we have also find the length of the line joining A and the centroid. Okay, so A and G. A is 0, 3 and G is 2, 1. Okay, so I'll hold this x1, y1, x2, y2. I'll put the distance formula, which is AG is equal to root over x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 whole squared. Okay, I'll just put the values and I'll get the answer. Root over x2 minus x1, 2 minus 0 plus y2 minus y1 whole square, 1 minus 3. Okay, so we get 2 squared plus minus 2 squared. 2 squared is 4 plus minus 2 squared is also 4. So we get the answer root 8. Root 8 is the length of the centroid from the vertex A. Okay, Now I'll end this video over here, guys. In the next video, we will solve a few basic advanced sums based on this particular chapter so that you get a better understanding of sectional formula. Till then, stay tuned. As always, goodbye, take care, and all the best.